you know, with each wave, things are washing away. It's history that we've never learned, and it's, you know, our roots to place that is not there anymore. So that's why we think it's so important to, you know, be able to understand these landscapes. We are running out of time because sea level is rising very fast. These storms are happening every time more often, every time more intense. These are pages of history books that we have not read.
Welcome to Wavelengths, where we talk about our planet with experts from Scripps Institution of Oceanography, covering everything from the deep sea to the edge of the atmosphere. I'm Kate Furby, a marine biologist and journalist. I got my PhD here a few years ago, and now I'm back, learning more about what's happening at Scripps. Hi, I'm here today with Isabel Rivera-Collazo. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks so much for receiving me.
I'm really like excited to tell this story. So I know that your research is on understanding people's history and their connections to place. And I was hoping we could start by having you tell us a little bit about this place where we are today.
Well, we are in the ancient territory of the Kumeyaay peoples. It stretches from about Escondido south all the way into Mexico. They are the ancestral owners of this place. Actually, there are several ancient sites of their ancestors right under this area.
I know you were just in Puerto Rico doing field work, and you got like emergency authorization to go. So tell me what brought you into the field this year.
Because I work on climate change, one of the impacts that climate change is having over Puerto Rico's cultural heritage is coastal erosion. Like since 2015, I have been keeping an eye out on how erosion is affecting the archaeological sites. We designed our survey to walk along the coast looking for archaeological artifacts, and that would include pottery, fragments of pottery, stone tools, food remains. Whenever we found something, we could do two things. Either if the objects were out of context, which would mean just thrown on top of the sand, we would collect a point and register what there is. But if the artifacts were in context, and that would mean inside layers in the area where the people in the past threw them, in areas that are archaeological, we would then use a grid to do an observation. And that is 1 meter square that we would put on the ground and do all of our observations inside that space, because that way we could be systematic about the process of observation. We would also take zoom-in photos of individual artifacts. And because when you take a photograph, it could be very close up or very far away, we put a scale. And the scale is just a piece of a ruler that marks sizes.
What does it feel like to pick up an artifact?
Yeah, it's knowing that it's the first time that someone has seen and touched these artifacts in maybe thousands of years. So it's very exciting to have that link to the past, and also to be able to tell a little bit of stories.
One thing about these sites, though, is you said there weren't a lot of written records of the history. So some of these sites are the sole recorders of the history that we have left?
Yeah, so these sites were coastal settlements. We think they may have been groups of roundhouses in pre-Columbian style called bohíos. The bohíos would be grouped around a central open area called batey. These villages covered the entire landscape. And in between the villages, next to the river mouth, there were ceremonial centers with multiple plazas like Playa Machuca. But it's been so many hundreds of years that not only the abandoned settlements are now buried under sand, but the coastline has changed dramatically. And with sea level rise and increased storms from climate change, this is only getting worse.
Humans are transforming the planet so rapidly that we're losing things potentially before we've even realized that they're there.
Yeah, and we see that constantly with archaeological sites. We don't know where the sites are, and they are so important. They are so important for finding solutions. They are important for our identity. They are important to rediscover our own voices, the things that happened in the past. and they are washing away. But we cannot sit back and wait. But by partnering with communities, by partnering with the people that are living there for whom these things are important, we can get things done. We can start answering questions. We can start finding solutions. We can start talking about the importance of climate adaptation, climate mitigation. We can start having those conversations about why we should change our behavior. Things might look challenging. We can do something. It's just a matter of figuring out what we can do and start doing it.